In this lesson, you will learn how to create basic glass material with Vray and 3ds Max. We're going to start with a basic glass material. Open the material editor and create a new Vray mat. Select your object and assign the material. In the reflection section, change the reflect color from black to white. Do the same for the refract color. This way we get 100% reflective and refractive material. As you can see, our glass does not look transparent at all right now. That's because the reflections are at the maximum from all angles. To fix this, check the Fresnel effect and keep the IOR value at 1.6 for glass. Now the reflection's visibility changes according to the viewing angle. The IOR value controls the ratio between the reflection visibility and the viewing angle. In other words, a higher value of IOR makes stronger reflections, and the other way around. To control the blurriness of the reflection, reduce the reflect glossiness to a value lower than 1.0. The subdivision controls the quality of the blurriness. High value will increase the quality, as well as render time. In real life, no material is perfect, so for a clear glass, I like to set a glossiness value of 0.99. The refraction section has its own IOR value, let's keep it at 1.6. The max depth determines how many surfaces a ray of light should be reflected on. If we set the depth value too low, we will get unrealistic results. To determine the right value, we can use the Exit Color tool. Turn it on and select a strong red color. Let's try it with a max depth of 5. If you can see the red exit color, you should set a higher depth value. A value of 8 to 10 is good for most cases. We can turn the exit color off for now. To make a frosted glass, we can simply reduce the refraction glossiness. Increase the refract subdivision for smoother results. I'm going to keep it on 8 for faster render. Bring the refract glossiness back to 1. Our last example will be tinted glass. In the fog color, set a very light blue tint. Note how the fog color gets less visible in the thin parts of the glass as opposed to the thick parts. To control the overall strength of the fog effect, you can increase or decrease the fog multiplier. Let's apply the fog effect on the shadow as well by checking the Effect Shadow button. Finally, let's make our glass a bit more interesting by inserting a simple texture in the bump slot. I'm going to drag and drop a black and white texture of a simple grid. To view the texture on the object, change the refract color back to black for now. Go to the texture and click on Show Shaded Material on Viewport. I'm going to rotate it to 45 degrees. Now you can bring the refract color back to white.